from. So right now what we're doing is we're prepping the floor for hardwood. If you look here, you have half room is our exposed concrete, the other half is the existing carpet. The reason being is a lot of times when you're doing the new tongue and groove engineered, you don't need to prep the whole floor at the same time. The old legacy wood was more of a structural thing that had to attach straight to floor joists. The new stuff is much weaker, it's less structural. It's more of a cosmetic thing, so you would always install it over an existing surface, substrate, or subfloor. All right, now what we're doing here is we're gonna remove the tack strips. A lot of people are transitioning, obviously, from the carpet that was installed, you know, the carpet phase of the 70s, 60s, 70s, and 80s, even early 90s now are transitioning back more into a solid surface or hardwood, things of that nature. So you're gonna run into this quite a bit when you're gonna have carpet tack strips will usually be on a perimeter. These were walls, these were carpet closets here. So these existed, you're not gonna usually have them in the middle of the floor like this. More commonly, they're gonna be in the perimeter of the room, right in front of the baseboard. So this is just a quick, goofy little thing, technique to take things out. A lot of times the things that we think are the easiest are the most frustrating because we don't do them properly. So this is a quick technique. So here's a little different. 8 out of 10 times you're gonna be pulling these carpet tack strips out of wood. It will be the solid surface, old legacy hardwood. So it is a very strong wood. When it comes to removing the nails or spikes out of concrete, what you never wanna do is to go in between this. Okay, you're pulling. Then, oh no, it broke off here, nail's still in here. Dang it. And you get this kind of thing here. So, one thing you're gonna wanna do, always make sure whatever you're using, you center it under the nail. You're gonna let it sit on the floor, take your hand out of the equation, and it's just as a guide, but it sits on the floor underneath, and you pop, pops it right out. Again, pops it right out. So this way, now if you do make the mistake here, I'll show you here. If you do this and you leave a nail still in the floor, then here's your contingency plan. Anytime you put pressure on something, hard surface to hard surface, you're gonna pop the head right off. So just like that. So if you do make the mistake, you can still get the nail out pretty easily. That's a second step where if you just, again, here, underneath it here, see, it'll pop the nail right out. That's just a way to do it real quick so you don't waste time goofing off prepping the floor. See you later. All right, so a quick thing to note. We just went over removing carpet tack strips from floor. So you're gonna have two, these are both pry tools. Oh, they both look, you know, they could be, you know, scrapers. These are multi-purpose tools. You're gonna look at one, could be used more as a putty knife, usually for spackling. You're not really gonna do compound with this, it's much too small. Spackling holes, things like that. These are very good when you're you want to get behind something without creating much damage. This is going to be much better to pry with or to remove something that is more difficult to remove. So one way you can tell, see, they're both made by Husky. One way you can tell though, you take this, you see how easily that moves. This is not going to be a very good pry tool. You're going to get under something, it's going to bend, you're going to break it. It's not going to pull it up. This here, very, very, very solid. Other thing you can do is, you look here, this is not made to hit with a hammer. This here is. And also, you unscrew that, you can do a tab pole attachment, you can get up high with it. So this here is made so you can beat the back of it with a hammer or mallet or something like that. This here is not. If you do it over time, this is gonna break off. So remember, really the way to check it is if you wanna remove something hard that you really wanna pry, even though they both will be multi-tools, both can be used as scrapers, just check how flexible the blade are. This is gonna be much thinner. You're gonna be able to easily move it with your fingers. This, not so much. So keep that in mind when you're utilizing certain tools for various projects.